Alright, so some people are very confused that I would say bad things about the baritone, or as I like to call it in an effort to specify, the baritone saxophone. I'm talking about this. Alright, so we've got a lead pipe of some size, we've got some cylindrical tubing. And it's obviously more than what a euphonium would have. Alright, so an American euphonium is not a baritone. This is a baritone. What is the problem that I have with this? Quite simply, it sucks. Let me show you. So, let's try some mouthpieces here. Now, let's go with something more basic with it. Start with the con 2. This is a precision con 2. This is not a precision air horn, this is an artist air horn. I do not have a stock mouthpiece for this, or even a mouthpiece with the right shank, because people want $80 for them. I'm not paying that much, I'd pay about $5 for one if I could. But, artist era baritone shank is 10.95 at about 6%. Precision series is 10.95 at 1 to 19. So it's going to stop in the right place. And that's good enough. So let's play some El Capitan. Let's hear how great this thing is. What resonant tone? That's a lot of effort. Let's use something a little more hopefully suitable. Con 3A. Get this nice, kind of sort of deep in a way, V cup. 22.5 millimeter wide. We're getting smaller. Let's see if that helps. Sorry, I have nerve damage, okay? I just got back from work. I'm a little slow. No, that doesn't help. That made it sound really bad. I mean, listen to that wonderful tone. You impressed yet? Alright, what is this? Hold on. Let me introduce this. This is a Josef Klier TH-12D on 11 millimeter at 1 to 19 shank. I had this made to basically just to test it, and I got pretty darn close on the first try. The precision small shank is approximately 1 to 19, close enough. And it's actually 10.95, not 11, so, you know, 1 millimeter off. Who cares? Shove us in! Trust me, that extra millimeter of gap is only gonna help this thing. Now, to its credit, this horn doesn't fall on its face the minute I give it some cup volume. Although we are looking down a 6 millimeter throat. Hold on. You sure how this is done? Alright. Same mouthpiece, correct receiver. Faster valves don't make me any better when we got static in between hand and brain, but which would you rather have? I know you're thinking, you're still not sold. Where's this mouthpiece issue? Alright, hold on, one more. Alright, so surely Besson can make a baritone sax horn, right? That's what I thought. That's why I spent big time money on this. So, let's see. Here we go. I had this thing already made because I'm a maniac. This is Joseph Clear EU12B. So it's basically as deep as a Bach 5G, 24 millimeter wide cup, and reverse engineered Euroshank. This thing plays excellent on my Besson Euphonium. I love the sound. So let's see what it does on here. And don't worry, we're not going to need a tuner. Going flat. So I thought, well, maybe there's something wrong with my reverse engineered shank, right? You might say that, right? Here's a Besson 10. This is a little tiny medium shank mouthpiece. A little small guy. Not your big mouthpiece. Is that even concert, eh? Nope, that ain't it. So here we go. See how much cup volume we're giving up here to go from euphonium to baritone? So about 5 millimeters shallower now. Barely. No, baritone sucks, man. Sorry.